Home is where the heart is, and home builders in the U.S. will be taking heart from the latest set of data, which shows a sector in strong rebound mode. U.S. housing starts, that's when ground is broken on home construction projects, hit a five-month high in July. Analysts say the 2.1% increase was better than expected. Now, all that activity is having an impact on the nation's two biggest home improvement stores. Home Depot sales at stores open 13 months or more rose by 4% in the second quarter. Net sales up 6.6% for over a year, rising just 2%. Net sales, however, were 5.3%. Both basically sell the same items like tools, paint, and garden furniture. But Lowe's says its results were hurt by its purchase of Canadian home improvement retailer Rona earlier this year. All right, let's get more on the U.S. housing market and a look at its recovery. And for that, we're joined by Stephen Bean. He is the Executive Managing Director at Situs. Stephen, thanks for joining us.
Glad to be here, Michelle.
So, Stephen, we have new home construction rising unexpectedly in July, up 2.1%. At the same time, we had a slip in new home permit applications, down 0.1%. Then we have some good data from the National Association of Home Builders saying that home building confidence climbed in August. What do you make of this mixed data?
I think you're going to continue to see mixed data. I think just like we've seen with unemployment, it's some months it's high, some months it's low. And I just think there's too many instability things in the global economy that's impacting us, and there's too much uncertainty out there, and therefore you're going to continue to see a little bit of this.
But we have still seen an upward trend in the housing market. We had these housing starts up in July, and then we had the purchases of new U.S. single-family homes rising in June to the highest level in more than 8 years. So there is some strength there. What is driving the strength in the housing market?
I think part of that is just wage growth is starting to catch up with home appreciation a little bit. I think there's beginning to be a little more inventory on the market. Initially, we had a lot of international buyers, and they've started to slow down, so it's given a little bit more inventory back to the guys that are getting the jobs and having wage increases.
Are we seeing international buyers slow down? I mean, something like the Brexit, surely that may bring in more foreign money to the U.S.?
We're starting to see a little bit. There was a lot over the last few years, and it's absolutely starting to slow down a little bit right now.
And where is the slowdown coming from, and why do you see that?
Well, they've primarily been investing in some of the major markets, and which have been some of our hotter markets, New York, San Francisco, L.A., Miami. They've been really driving a lot of the growth in those markets.
Do you think, though, that with the strong U.S. dollar compared to the pound and compared to the renminbi, for example, that will deter foreign buyers or encourage them?
That's a good question. That may be one of the reasons why it slowed down.
Well, which areas are seeing the biggest price increases so far?
In the housing market?
In the U.S.
It's been those major hot markets, the New York, San Francisco.
So overall, do you think that the strong housing data is congruent with the fundamentals of the economy?
I think what you're seeing is some mix, and I think it is congruent because of that very reason, because there is some global instability out there that's driving some of these factors.
There is some mixed results. As we said, housing starts up, but even with mortgage interest rates at record lows, total mortgage applications down 4% in the last report. Is this just a blip or just congruent with what you're saying, that it's just mixed data so far?
Same thing, mixed data. I mean, even Freddie Mac said that this year is going to be the first year where we have $2 trillion of mortgages. And a lot of those mortgages are refinances today because interest rates are so low.
Well, let's talk about interest rates, because the latest Fed minutes indicate that there could be a hike coming sooner or later. The Fed minutes saying that some members think a rate hike was or would soon be warranted. And as we dissect every word from the Fed, the big focus is on the word soon. Do you think we're going to see a September hike?
I don't think we'll see a September hike. I think there's several factors why, but it goes back to global instability. Also, it's election year, and we rarely see too much rate movement right before the election.
So assuming if we get a rate hike, which would only be 25 basis points, and assuming that happens one time by the end of the year, what impact would that have on the housing market?
I don't know that it's going to have too much of an impact. And a little bit of it has to do with the international rates. We've got so many countries that are at zero or negative interest rates. And therefore, how much is that going to really drive rates? Or mortgage rates are really driven more by Treasury yields. And those yields, I don't think even a small bump in rates will tremendously impact those Treasury yields, just because of the low interest rates in the other countries.
All right, well, thank you so much, Stephen Bean, Executive Managing Director at Citus.